Hey guys, welcome back to Flatback Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you a super simple way to fix some of the most common green screen issues inside of After Effects. So stick around, you're watching Flatback Effects. So this is the second part of my green screen series. In part one, I showed you how to identify the problem at the point of filming to help avoid the issue. And in this part, I'll show you a super easy approach to fixing these green screen issues inside of After Effects. In this video, I'm going to show you a really easy five-step process to deal with 90% of the green screen issues inside of After Effects. Now, there are many different techniques for pulling a good key, and many can turn quickly into you losing your mind. The best ones are the ones that are simple. Complicated, put simply, does not work. The approach I like to use is called the five stages of not losing your shit. Now, I've used a lot of color keyers over various programs, and in my opinion, the best is Red Giant's Primac Keyer. But with a price tag of $500, most casual home users are not going to buy it. So as an alternative, I'm going to use After Effects' built-in program Keylight, which if used correctly can achieve the same results. Now if you're going to do a lot of keying, I recommend buying Primat as it's just a lot simpler and yields great results in much less time. Alright, so with that, let's get started. Now I've just got a simple green screen shot here that I'm going to use for this example. So I've created a new composition and I've dragged my footage in. Next, I'm going to add Keylight and I'm going to come over to the color picker and I'm going to select the brightest point. Now most people will tell you to select the midpoint. The reason I suggest the brightest point is because it will preserve the most information in the shadows for us to work with. Now the shadows are generally the hardest points to deal with, so I find it better to select the highlights to preserve as much information in those shadows as possible. Now in step two, we need to adjust the gain until it starts to affect your subject. So basically I come over to where it says screen gain, and I need to drag this up until it starts to affect the actual subject, which is the thing we want to preserve. So you can see I've dragged this up too high already, so I'm just going to back this off. And it looks about right there. So this is where I like to adjust the screen balance. If you have a lot of spill, this is where we'll try and compensate for some of that difference. So all I need to do is adjust this to remove the green tinge, but I don't want to make my image too red. Now that's starting to look pretty good there. Now you're probably thinking, this actually looks really great. But in the next step, you'll see that looks can be very deceiving. Now to see finer detail, we turn our view to screen matte. This is basically showing you the black, which is transparent or see-through, and white, which is opaque or solid. In this view, we can see straight away that there are a few areas that are not quite right. We basically want the green screen to be solid black and your subject to be solid white. If we come down to the screen mat and drag the white level down, we can add more to our subject. At the same time we are doing this, we can also bring our black level up to compensate. Now once you think you've got it pretty close, I can then switch my view back to final results and then just make adjustments from here. So in this particular case, this has given me a hard edge that I kind of want to make a little bit softer, and that looks about right there. Now it's only a matter of just repeating the process. Basically there are many additional things you can do, but it's all about doing a balancing act between those simple steps. Now that is pretty much 90% of green screen. Most of the issues you're going to have, you can fix with those simple steps. So let's have a look at a few other examples and we can see how we can go about fixing them. All right, so here's a little bit of a harder one. On the surface, it looks quite simple, but we've got some glasses here and they've got a little bit of reflection. So I'm going to start the process again by coming up to keying and adding my key light. I'm going to select my brightest point again. That actually looks pretty good there. I'm just going to drag my balance over. That looks pretty good. Now what I've got here is I like to create a solid background and I make this red, and this just helps point out any differences. So here we can already see that in this area here, we've got a lot of spill. So if I actually go back to the original, you can see this, you can see how green it is. So this is a very common problem you'll find when working with green screen. Basically what we need to do is we need to try and use our mat to get more information back into this. So I'm gonna go down to my screen mat and I'm gonna start to bring these down. It's all about a balancing act of just fine tuning this. And I'm gonna go back to my final results just to have a look. Now it's starting to look better already, but the more I bring these down, you can see we've pretty much lost all that spill. Now, if there's a little bit of spill left there, you can actually just use this just to color correct it. And that actually looks really good. So let's go on to another example. So here we've got this lady who actually has a little bit of spill on the side here. She's wearing a white top, which is generally a very hard thing to pull a key on. So what we're going to do is we're going to add our key light again. This time I'm going to select the highlight to start. And then I'm just going to adjust this. So I'm going to back this off slightly, losing a little bit of information in here. This is the problem you'll run into with white. So I'm just going to then switch to my screen mat. So you can see we've got quite a bit of noise up here and we've got quite a bad key there. So we're just going to add a little bit more information back in there and then take the rest of that out in the black. Now that starts to look pretty good there. We're going to go back to our final results. And there you go. So that already starts to look much better than what we had. Now you can actually fine tune this further. One thing you can do is you can come up to the screen shrink and you can actually just drag this up and down. You can also mess around with this screen softness and that's just going to soften some of these edges. So it'll just go from a harder edge to a slightly softer edge. Now, as we know, the green screen doesn't have to fill the whole screen. We only need to fill our subject. Now, when you get a shot like this, before you apply the green screen, what we're actually going to do is we're just going to draw a really quick mask so that it covers just the screen. Then we're going to apply our key light and I'm simply just going to select a highlight. Next, I'm going to drag my gain up and that actually looks really good there, but we'll just double check through the screen mat. We can see we've got quite a bit of detail missing there. So I'm just going to bring this white down again. I'm going to bring this up just to make sure we've got all of that information. Go back to my final results and there you go. Now here we've got another common problem where we've got a darker spot and then we've got highlights. We've also got a few lights in the shot here. So we're going to start again by adding our key light. This time I'm going to select the highlight and now I'm just going to adjust my screen gain. Then I'm going to switch to my screen mat. I'm going to add a little bit of white back in there, darken this black down. And that's how easy it is. Now, like I said, you can mess around with a few of those settings there, but that's the basic idea. Now, in this one, we could easily draw a mask around these two just to get rid of these lights. But if we played through the clip, we'd actually see that this actor's head actually passes in front of these lights. So the only way we can actually get around this is you have to do what we call a rotoscope. So you'd actually have to go frame by frame and cut around the actor's head to essentially cut him out of the scene. Now, rotoscoping I'm not going to cover in this tutorial, but I will be covering that in a later tutorial. Now, just to finish, we've got quite a tricky one here, which is preserving shadows. So this is another big issue you'll run into when pulling a green screen. So we approach it in the same way. We come up to our effect and we create our key light. I'm also just going to take this opportunity to draw a quick mask around my scene. And then I'm just going to select a highlight part of the screen, try and preserve as much of that information as possible. And I'm just going to bring this up slightly. Next, I'm just going to switch to my screen mat. Now, in this particular case, we're trying to preserve the actual shadow information. So as you can see, when we've come back, we've actually lost this top part of the shadow. Now, a very simple way to deal with this is you could actually just rotoscope the shadow and then pull a key separate. So you'd end up with two layers. But if we want to try and do it in one, we basically then need to restart the process. So in our final results view, we'd then go back to our screen gain and we'd start to drag this back the other way to add more information in. As we're doing this, we're going to go back down to the clip the blacks and we're just going to bring this back up as well. So here I've just prepared this one earlier just to show you. I've also added a little bit of screen blur which will just help soften out this shadow here. And I'm going to turn on the background just to see how it's actually looking. Now if I actually play through this, if you watch the shadow, you'll see that it's actually darting around a lot. So this is where you can make a common mistake, where you think that this is because you've actually taken that information out of the shadow, when in fact it was actually in the original footage. So this is actually a really good example to go back and actually look at the detail prior. And if I actually look closely at the shadow, I can see there's actually a bit of noise in that. So the reality is, this is a good example where you know you're never going to get a perfect key. So in this case, I would probably go with the rotoscope option of actually rotoscoping that shadow separately to try and preserve as much information. So that's part two of fixing the most common issues with green screen, and hopefully you've learned something. So this five-step process is a really simple way to be able to deal with 90% of the issues that you'll have with green screens. Now that other 10% is where you'll spend 80% of your time trying to finesse each of the details to get the best possible key. But from a basic keying point of view, and most of the stuff that I see and deal with, this will work absolutely fine. Like I said before, the more you learn how to fix the issue, the more you'll be able to identify the issue. Now, if you've got some green screen footage you're having some trouble with, feel free to put your question in the comment section below, or you can email me directly at flatpackeffects@gmail.com. Now remember to enter your comments in my prize draw for your chance to win a free gift card. Details are in the description below. Thanks for watching, and remember, Flatpack Effects is the flat pack anyone can build.